Hi, this is Leah from Open Intro. In this video, we will see how to use normal approximation for a binomial distribution and the distribution of a sample proportion. It is believed that nearsightedness affects about 8% of all children. We are interested in finding the probability that fewer than 12 out of 200 randomly sampled children will be nearsighted. A. Estimate the probability using the normal approximation to the binomial distribution. Before we go ahead and do this, let's first verify that this scenario does create a binomial distribution. We're looking at out of 200. And whenever you hear this many out of n, that makes us think binomial. And so we have n is 200, p is given as 0.08, and because they're randomly sampled, we can consider the draws to be independent. So it is a binomial distribution, and we want fewer than 12. So we want the probability that x will be less than 12. And now we can find the mean and standard deviation of this binomial distribution with these shortcut formulas here. And so we're going to have mu, the mean is np, and the standard deviation, sigma, is square root of np, 1 minus p. So plugging in the n of 200 and the p of 0.08, we'll get a mean of 16 and a standard deviation of 3.84. So on average, we expect to see about 16 nearsighted children in our sample, and give or take 4 or so. And now let's check that we can use normal approximation on this binomial distribution. We need np and n1 minus p to be at least 10. So np is 200 times the 0.08, that's greater than or equal to 10, and the n1 minus p is also greater than or equal to 10. So now we can find our z-score, which is going to be the value of interest. So the value of interest x here is 12, and then I'm going to subtract the average that we calculated and the SD that we calculated. So that's going to look like 12 minus 16 over the 3.84. That's going to give us a z-score of negative 1.04. And now, again, because we're doing fewer than, we want to shade to the left. So we're going to be looking for the area to the left of negative 1.04 under the normal curve. So using whatever technology you prefer, we can use a TI here. We'll go to second vars and choose number 2, which is norm CDF. We wanted less than negative 1.04, so our lower bound is going to be a big negative number, so let's say negative 6, and our upper bound is going to be the negative 1.04, and hit enter a few times, and we'll get 0.149, so 0.1492. And that's our answer to the original question, the probability that fewer than 12 have this property. Part B, estimate the probability using the distribution of the sample proportion. So here we're interested in seeing the probability that fewer than 12 out of 200 have this property. 12 out of 200 is 0.06. So rather than finding the probability that x is less than 12, we're just going to find the probability that p hat is less than 0.06. And so we can use the formulas mu and sigma for p hat. So mu is just going to be 0.08. Sigma is going to be the square root of p1 minus p over n. And that gives us this 0.0192. We've already checked that the normal approximation is good. It's the same rule, np, n1 minus p. N and p are the same in this problem. And so now we can find our z-score. It's our value of interest, which is given here, 0.06 minus the calculated average divided by the calculated SD. And so that's going to be the 0.06 minus 0.08 divided by 0.0192. That's going to give us a z-score of negative 1.04. And if we shade to the left of that, yes, we're going to get 0.1492, which is our answer to the original question. Part C. How do your answers from parts A and B compare? Well, they were the same, right? Because the questions are equivalent. In part A, we wanted to know what's the probability we get fewer than 12. And in part B, we wanted to know what's the probability that the proportion is less than 0.06. But if you get 12 out of 200, that means you got 6%. So these two questions are equivalent. And so when we find the mean and standard deviation here of the binomial, of course we get different values when we find the mean and the standard deviation of the sample proportion. However, when we standardize those values using this 12 here and using this 0.06 here, we get exactly the same z-score. And so we get the same probability. Because again, those are equivalent ways of doing the problem. So you really can do these problems whichever way you prefer. Sometimes it's worded in a way that suggests binomial more because it's a how many question. Sometimes it's worded in a way that suggests using a sample proportion because it explicitly says what's the probability the sample proportion will be less than whatever. However, you can use either method. That's it for this video. For more free resources, check us out at openintro.org.